Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Alhamdulillah. Salatu wassalamu ala Rasulillah. الرحمة المهداة والنعمة المصطفى له ولله الحمد من سيئات الأعمال ما يهدي الله ورحمة الحكم المؤمن ولن تجد له ولي الباب الثالث
الباب الثالث
في بيان العدل واجتناب الظلم في المعاملة في بيان العدل واجتناب الظلم في المعاملة
Yeah, I've got that, but within that, are you starting from the beginning of it?
Yeah, because I just did the two sentences, remember? And then we have to... Okay. قال اعلم أن المعاملة قد تجري على وجه يحكم المفتي بصحتها وانعقادها ولكنها تجتمع على ظلم يتعرض به المعامل لسخط الله تعالى. He said that you might have the contract legally is correct, fiqh wise is correct, meaning that the surface of it, but the essence of it, there's some injustice in it that it make a person be vulnerable to the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we gave examples of that last time, you remember? That a person can have a contract, in the surface of it, it looks all right. Like, I can have you, I know that you are in need. I said, I want you to spend all my home, or pay $10. You said, yeah. For you work for all the home for $10. The contract, there's ijab and qabul, there's an offer, the acceptance, there's a money exchange and so forth. There's no riba and so, but there's injustice in it. I took the advantage of your vulnerability, like child labor. You know, that kind of things. And that's why in Islam, for example, a person might wipe on their shoes in wudu. But the ulama said if the shoes were stolen shoes, the wudu is not valid. Because if somebody sees you have all the criterion of criterion on the shoes. The exact, the best, you know, all of this condition of being fulfilled on the shoes, and it's okay for you to wipe on it. But it is from the Sharia perspective, the shoes were stolen. ولا يجوز الوضوء بالماء المغصوب. Person making wudu, but it's stolen water. Wudu is not valid. Because the water has been stolen. ولا يجوز الصلاة على الأرض المغصوبة. Person cannot pray in the land been confiscated. ولا يجوز جزء بناء المسجد عليها. It's not permissible to build even a masjid on confiscated land. Therefore, it might appear from Sharia perspective a person have fulfilled what? The conditions and the requirement, but the essence of it is a problem. There's something wrong with that. Right? He says that there's a ways of things that in business dealing are not acceptable out there as completely haram, yes, outright haram, it's not acceptable. قال القسم الأول فيما يعم ضرره وهو أنواع. In Islamic law, the principle is that لا ضرر ولا ضرار. No harm be committed, nor a person should put themselves in harmful situation. And also, الضرر يزال. Harm has to be removed. والضرورة تقدر بقدرها, and the harms has to be merged with the actual cause of it, or the impact of it. Now, for the fiqh رفع الضرر, fiqh رفع الضرر, the fiqh of removing harm, that's a big fiqh, a very vast bab in abwab al-fiqh, you know, a discipline within the fiqh itself. والضرر أنواع. Harms in business are many types. النوع الأول, the first type of ضرر, of harm, الاحتكار. الاحتكار. What do you mean by الاحتكار?
It's hoarding.
Holding.
Hoarding.
Huh?
Hoard.
Hoard. Mm-hmm. Hoarding.
Yeah, it's an R.
Yes. But also means to hold out, to keep the merchant or the good until the price goes up, especially an issue of food. It's not permissible. قال الاحتكار وبايع الطعام يدخر الطعام ينتظر به غلاء الأسعار. The person who sells food hold the food until the price goes up. What that person trying to create in the dynamic of business?
Monopoly,
but demand. You creating a demand
and lowering the supply.
Lowering supplies, not because the people like want to buy these things only, but because it is not there, and therefore they become more demand for it, and therefore you can't have the monopoly of rising the price or raising the price the way you want, because a person have to buy bread, a person have to buy rice, a person have to buy milk, a person have to buy those kind of things before you raise the price. So that you manipulate the market. They used to do this a lot of sugar. Sugar price very much manipulated. You create demand, you withdraw the sugar from the market, so you raise the price so that people can buy, you can sell it the way you want it.
Well, you could argue that that's what's being done with oil and OPEC.
Yes. Oil, yes. It's oil to control the market, the supplies. Right. But they don't create nudra. The nudra, that means the thing that is not out there. You know, sometimes they reduce the price to stabilize the price. But sometimes then when person completely withdraw from the market, then you make the price completely unreasonable. It's not reasonable at all. You know, you have people selling the most valuable things to buy food. You know? Sometimes you ask people, the farmer, for example, to burn wheat or to dump them into the ocean. We do that even here. To keep the market value stable so that you don't lose the market value. You know?
Can you read? Can you translate من احتكى الطعام 40 يوما ثم تصدق به لم تكن سرقة كفارة للاحتكار.
نعم وهو كمل. وهو ظلم عام is injustice being committed for not only one person. The danger of احتكار, I wronged you, that's one to one. I wronged the whole masjid, I'm in trouble. I wronged the whole city, I'm even trouble. I hold the all continent, I'm even, you know what I mean? The more I spread my zulm, I'm more in trouble. Because now I'm touching so many people. وَهُوَ ظُلْمٌ عَامٌ وَصَاحِبُهُ مَذْمُومٌ فِي الشَّرْحِ. And the person who commit this have been what? Zam in Arabic, عَكْسُ الْمَدْحِ. What zam?
Like blameworthy.
Being blameworthy. Okay? Disliked. Unwanted person. You know? طيب. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. وإن كان الحديث ضعيف. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من احتكر الطعام 40 يوما. Whoever held food for 40 days. ثم تصدق به. لم تكن صدقته كفارة لاحتكاره. If a person were to hold food for 40 days to create kind of tremendous need for people to the food, he said, even if he gave it for sadaqa after 40 days, he's not completely making up for what he did.
So the sadaqa doesn't make it.
Yeah, because he hurt people in the process. You don't know what happened to the people who that they felt, you know, just out of food for 40 days. You put them in harsh difficulty. وروى أن ابن عمر رضي الله عنه وروى ابن عمر رضي الله عنه أن صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال من احتكر الطعام 40 يوما فقد برئ من الله فقد برئ من الله وبرئ الله منه. That person who have held the food and did ihtikar for 40 days as if he said, I have nothing to do with Allah, and Allah has nothing to do with him.
It is food only, right?
Food only. Here, what food? وقيل فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا. As if he have killed all humanity. Because by holding food, you can cause people to die sometimes. Cause death. وعن علي رضي الله عنه علي reported رضي الله عنه كرم الله وجهه من احتكر الطعام 40 يوما قسى قلبه. هذا قول علي رضي الله عنه. Whoever hold food or hoard food for 40 days, his heart become harder. This hardness of his heart. قسى قلبه. And it is true. قسى قلبه. Because a person does that, doesn't care about people when he holds food. وعنه أيضا أنه أحرق طعام محتكر بالنار. A person who put, you know, food and put it, they burn it. So that they tell him that he cannot do that. وروي في فضل ترك الاحتكار عنه صلى الله عليه وسلم and the reward for the person does not do احتكار. قال من جلب طعاما فباعه بسعر يومه فكأنما تصدق به. Whoever brought the food and sell it with the market value of the day as if have given sadaqah of it, of all of it. Allah, he made business, made money. You hear that? Whoever brought food to the market, من جلب طعاما فباعه بسعر يومه. He sold the food with the price of that day. فكأنما تصدق به. As if have given it in sadaqah. وفي لفظ آخر فكأنما أعتق رقبة. As if that person have freed a slave. Why? What the connection of freeing a slave and selling the food at the market value of the day? Because في الطعام استرقاق. When you have people become in need of food, they become enslaved. Freedom. وقيل في قوله تعالى وما يريد فيه بإلحاد وظلم نذق من عذاب أليم. Whoever intend this is in the haram, that if a person in the haram بإلحاد وظلم نذق من عذاب أليم, قال إن الاحتكار من الظلم وداخل تحته في الوعيد. That they said, and this is during Hajj time, because people in Hajj become in need of food. But if you hold the food from the Hajjis, so they have been trapped, you know, they're one place, they don't know where to go. You hold the food and you jack the price for them to create a demand. That is committing wrong. وعن بعض السلف أنه كان بواسط. ما هي واسط؟ وعن بعض السلف أنه كان بواسط فجهز سفينة حنطة إلى البصرة وكتب إلى وكيله بيع هذا الطعام يوم يدخل البصرة ولا تؤخره إلى غدا. And one of the Salaf He was in the area called Wasit. This Wasit, the name of it today is Al-Qut. Al-Qut. You know it? It is in Iraq. And it is the like a Shibhi Jazeera, like a peninsula. Okay? بناها الحجاج بن يوسف. الحجاج بن يوسف got my way. He built that.
Oh really?
Yeah. الحجاج built it.
واسط على الصيد.
واسط. وهي الآن أيضا مسمى بمحافظة. Just like a district. طيب. One of the things that in text you need to know. يسموه تعريف الأماكن والأسماء. When you read the text, when the place been mentioned for research purposes, you have to know what the place, what this place located. Does this place exist now? Does not exist. And when the name of a person been mentioned, you know, you get to get to know the person and to mention something about them. And I do this when I teach, like أيها الولد, like الشقيق البلخي comes in. I tell people who's شقيق البلخي. حاتم الأصم come in. I said people who حاتم الأصم. إبراهيم بن أدهم comes in. I say what إبراهيم بن أدهم. الشبلي can be mentioned. Who's the Shibli? But you have to try people to get to know those people as you teach. فهذه أنه كان بواسط فجهز سفينة. This one of the Salaf, it was in the area called Wasit, and he prepared the ship of حنطة. ما هي الحنطة؟ الحنطة هي القمح. قمح. القمح كل حنطة. ما هو القمح؟ ويت. What kind of wheat?
Before it's
the wheat that you make flour out of. Yes.
Does hanta a different type of wheat?
Yeah, no. Al-hanta. Al-qabh, yeah.
The same thing or is it different?
Huh?
Is it slightly different or is it the same thing?
Same. And it may be the whole level of the hanta. إلى البصرة وكتب إلى وكيله. And he wrote to the person, his representative, he wrote to him, the person, the salesperson, who is going to sell this in his behalf. Okay? Sell this food the day that the food enter Basra. The day that the Basra, we know what Basra is. Basra is? It's in Iraq.
Southern Iraq.
Southern Iraq. The day that the food, this food enter Basra, sell it. What did he try to tell him? Sell it as what? With the price of
that day.
Don't hold it. Don't take it to storage to wait until the price goes up. Right? And do not let it stay until next day. فوافق ساعة في السعر. When the ship arrived, the price was what? It was low. Like, there's so many of hinta at there. فقال له التجار هذا الشياطين أتوا. And then the business people at the merchants, لو أخرته جمعة, if you delay for next week, next Friday, ربحت فيه أضعافه, you will double and triple your profit. What is the man said when he sent it?
He said
sell it.
Send it.
He said sell it the same day, don't wait next day. But the business people said, no, next Friday. Now Shaitan comes to you and says, you know, the price is going to go up. Wait, tripling the price. فَأَخَّرَهُ جُمَعَةً. The owner of the money said, sell it immediately. The salesperson delayed a whole week. فَرَبِحَ فِيهِ أَمْثَالُهُ He tripled the prizes. مثل means equal, the same. وَكَتَبَ إِلَى صَاحِبِهِ بِذَلِكَ And then he wrote back to the owner. He says, I made a lot of money. I did this, I delayed it, I held it. I did horto, you know, for a week. How the فكتب إليه صاحب الطعام the owner of the food he wrote him back يا هذا or this man إنا كنا قنعنا بربح يسير مع سلامة ديننا look at this he said I was content with a little profit and having my religion my faith intact سلامة ديننا قنعنا بربح يسير مع سلامة ديننا We will accept a small profit with saving my deen being saved. سلام الدينينا. وإنك قد خالفت. And you have violated what I asked you to do. وما نحب أن نربح ضعافه بذهاب شيء من الدين. I am not wish to have so much profits, multiple profits, with losing some of my deen. What a man. He said, I don't like for me to make a lot of profits and losing my soul. بذهاب شيء من الدين بشيء من a little of my religion, I don't want to lose it with a lot of money that you bring it to me. I'm not going to be able to justify that selling even a little bit of my deen with the lot of profits you brought to me. بشيء من الدين فقد جنيت علينا جناية جنيت جنا in Arabic is to what? To do what?
Murder.
Yeah, to murder or جناية هو it is you violate someone. You have violated us. You commit a violation against us. Like hitting somebody is called جناية. Killing somebody is called جناية. جنا عليه. You know? All is جناية.
Physical crime.
But you have violated us, you committed a crime against us. فَإِذَا أَتَاكَ كِتَابِي هَذَا When this letter of mine arrived to you, فَخُذِ الْمَالَ كُلَّهُ Take all the money, all of it. فَتَصَدَّقَ بِهِ عَلَى فُقَرَاءِ الْبَصْرَةِ He said, take all the money, even the capital. And give it away in sadaqah for people the need of Basra. I don't need this one. These people have taken the love of dunya away from their heart. They uprooted the dunya. They uprooted dunya. They uprooted it. Subhanallah.
وليتني أنجو من إثم الاحتكار كفافا لا علي ولا لي.
He said, even by doing this. I want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive my sin. I want to be even. كَفَافًا لَا عَلِيَّ وَلَا لِيَّ I didn't want the rewards from the sadaqah. I want to repair the damage. But if I become even, I'm okay. يعني some ulama says, الكفارات كفارة is to become even. Yani, see a person, as if a person walk onto the earth, and there's a well. A well has steps. A person made a violation of one of the Sharia. Not a sin that of repentance. There's something that, in order to have repentance, you have to have what? You have to have kafara. Therefore, they said that the kafara bring you back to the level. Okay? Now, لا علي ولا لي واعلم أن النهي مطلق ويتعلق بالنظر به في الوقت والجنس أما الجنس فيطرد النهي في أجناس الأقوات أما ليس بقوت ولا هو معين على القوت كالأدي والعقاقير والزعفران مثاله فلا يتعدى النهي عنه إليه وإن كان مطعوما Yani he said this things is based on food. Yani the all kind of foods are not permissible to do ihtikar on them. And fil waqt. And then also at the time where a person have held the food. الوقت والجنس. وأما الجنس فيطرد النهي في أجناس الأوقات أما ليس بقوت ولا هو معين على القوت كالأدي والعقاقير المدسن الأدر والزعفران والأمثالي ولا يتعدى النهي إليه وإن كان وضعهما even people who eat the certain things they eat it but it's not nutritious like sustain for people you know become essential. وأما ما يعين على القوت كاللحم والفواكه وما يسده مسدا يغني عن القوت في بعض الأحوال وإن كان يمكن المداومة عليه فهذا في محل النظر من العلماء من طرد التحريم في السمن والعسل. He said, some people say, is it only on bread and wheat and other things like that essential? Or does that include the meat and other, all other kind of food and samn, you know, which is the butter and honey? He says that all of them have included that, made the same qiyas. وأما الوقت فيحتمل أن طرد النهي في جميع الأوقات وعليه تدل الحكاية التي ذكرناها في الطعام الذي صادف في البصرة ساعة في الساعة. يعني is it okay if you have food and the price is so low and there's so many of the food in the market, is it okay to hold that food? Until the price goes up. He said there's so many things already in the market. I'm gonna hold it until the price goes up. Is that permissible or not? For this, what the scholar says here, that he said it doesn't matter. Because the story he just mentioned that the price was low. ويحتمل أن يخصص بوقت قلة الأطعمة وحاجة الناس إليه يكون في تقريبه ضر ما. أما إذا اتسعت الأضرب وكثر واستغنى الناس عنها ولم يلقوا فيها إلا بقيمة قليلة فانتظر صاحب الطعام ذلك ولم ينتظر قحطا وليس في هذا إضرار. الإمام الغزالي then made adjustment. He's saying that say you sell him banana. You brought your banana and your banana is green. Still. And you find there's so much banana that people become no value of the banana. And some of it even is spoiled, no one buying it. He said you can hold your banana until it become, you know, yellow, and you can sell it because people are not in need of the banana. Therefore, that is okay. He says the qiyas here, the issue here is that if there's a creating a demand where there's a harm been committed. You get my point? Therefore, you are a bakery person and you're baking bread, but you supply there's so much bread that there's some bread for 2 days not being sold. And even the bread inside what? They start going bad and people dump it in the trash. Because if you go now to the places where they sell bread, they by the end of the day, what they do to the bread?
They throw it out.
If you come to know that, then you're gonna say, I'm gonna reduce the amount of bread that I make. That's permissible. That's not ihtikar. وإذا كان الزمان زمان قحط وكان في ادخار العسل والسمن والشيرج وامتال إضرار وانبغي أن يقتضي بتحريمه ويعول في نفي التحريم وإثباته على الضرر فإنه مفهوم قطعا من تخصيص الطعام. He said, but if there is a drought and there is a need of even the butter and the honey and so forth and a person hold it from people, it is haram to do so. Because you're creating more hardship for people. طيب. وإذا لم يكن ضرار فلا يخلو احتكار الأوقات عن كراهية. He said, even if there is no particular harm and there is no doubt it be disliked. Even if it's not haram, it's disliked for sure. فإنه ينتظر مبادل الأضرار وهو ارتفاع الأسعار. That person waiting until the price goes up, and the price goes up also is darar. What I mean by that, if something was causing $50, it becomes costing $100, but the person is spending, he spend more $50. He said that that person is still borderline. Subhanallah. وانتظار بعد الضرار محظور كانتظار عين الإضرار ولكنه دونه. يعني there's a beginning of the harm, but it's not the real harm. He said also it's not permissible. Although it's less than it. وانتظار عين الضرار أيضا هو دون الضرار وبقدر درجات الإضرار تتفاوت درجات الكراهية والتحريم. This is يا يونس هذه قاعدة عامة. With the amount of the harm a person commit, or the level of the harm, the more sinful the things become. For example, if I do something, make person starve, that is haram. If I make something that person to starve to death and he die, then more is, you know what I mean? With the, how much impact of the harm, the person, the level of the harm that caused, a person become more, the sin become greater. You know what I mean? The more the harm become greater on the person, the greater the sin become. Islam is very beautiful, you know. The whole religion, all the idea of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to establish the relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make you understand everything under the sun is a creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you have to have the mu'amala that you've committed no harm, no hurt to them, and you cannot do anything in this world except what Allah permit. And anything that makes you in the position, playing in people's vulnerability and taking advantage over them is haram. You cannot take advantage of the vulnerability of the individuals. Period. Now, قال وبالجملة التجارة في الأقوات مما لا يستحب لأنه طلب ربح والأقوات أصوله خلقت قواما والربح من المزايا فانبقى يطلب الربح ما خلق من جملة المزايا التي لا ضرورة للخلق إليها ولذلك أوصى بعض التابعين رجلا يعني he made it a little bit he using his mystical here feeling about this he says it's better a way to stay from selling food better stay from selling food than getting the business of selling food so that he might not start playing with people with stomach. Meaning, here the food doesn't mean restaurant. It made the food mean the weed and the other things like that. Then you ask yourself that if people avoiding selling weed, what are you gonna do? It's job. You have a farmer, what the farmer gonna do? If you stop that, تعطلت الأرزاق, then who gonna farm? That's it. You know, he's saying that don't use this as the main trade to monopoly and increase the prices and so forth.
Manipulate the market.
And manipulating the market. Therefore, don't put the wheat in the stock market, but sell the wheat directly. Don't try to play with the options of wheat and so forth and so on. Don't play with that, okay? وذلك أوصى بعض التابعين رجلاً One of the تابعين gave advice to a person وقال لا تسلم ولدك في بيعتين ولا في صنعتين. He said, don't let your child be doing one of the two jobs. بيع الطعام وبيع الأكفان. وإنه يتمنى الغلاء وموت الناس. الغزالي رحمه الله. He said, don't let your child sell food or sell
kafan, casket. He said because in food, he want the price to go up, and the price goes up, that means people access to food become difficult. It's true, by the way. If the price of food goes up, the poor person cannot afford it. Isn't that what happened in America? If some people, they eat less nutrition food because they cannot afford real food. What he said, if your son becomes selling food, we eat another, then he will hope that the price goes up. He doesn't care who can afford it, who cannot afford it. And if you sell casket, he will wish people to die so he can more business. Wish death to people.
According to Mathab Jafari, selling, being in the business of selling kafan is makruh.
So it's the same thing in America, by the way.
So you can. So you say, how do you buy kafan? You just get part of like a shop that sells
materials. It's fabric. Yeah, that's true. That's true. And even they say a person should not take making and washing a body a job.
Right.
Washing the janaza. It's makruh. Mm-hmm. It's like to make that as a job because you're waiting for the people to die. لكنه إذا دفع له الناس, if somebody wash and somebody pay them, that's fine.
Right, as a like a
hadiyah or something. Okay. I remember that my grandfather said, Rahimullah, said, son, don't ever go visit a sick person or be in a janaza and somebody give you a hadiyah, accept it. He says, give it to somebody else. حتى لا يتعود قلبك. So that your heart does not, you know. They get permissible of the somebody give hadiyah for somebody, go to the wedding, or go to other things. But they say the death, so that person does not, instead of the death become a reminder to them, it become a profitable thing.
Right.
Get my point?
Yeah.
Or visiting somebody in the hospital. You visit somebody in the hospital and somebody says, you know, thank you for Sheikh coming reading Quran. You don't accept that money. He said, go and donate to the masjid. لا يتخذوا الناس زيارة المريض. Person should not take visiting a sick person for religious purposes an earning, nor praying on janaza or washing somebody. Strictly only for that. You see what I'm saying? Because هذا ربط شيء يعني يرقق القلب بشيء في الدنيا. You connect to something that's supposed to be in the heart or something of dunya, that your heart become very hard. You know what I mean? Washing the disease become an excitement rather than a softening of the heart because there's a money in dunya coming out of that. والصنعتان يكون جزارا وإنها صنعة تقسي القلب أو سواقا فإنه يصير زخرف الدنيا بالذهب والفضة. And he said this for the two things that he sells. And he says, and he just said that to his, this is not haram by the way. He said to them, don't let your son jab in always slaughtering animal. Because his heart become harder. And here it is not haram. Be careful in this one here. But Imam Al Ghazali said that somebody gave a tabi'in, واحد من التابعين, tell a man, they let him slaughter all the time, he's just slaughter animal. And don't let him all the time deal only with gold and silver and so forth. That doesn't mean the person cannot deal with those. By the way, he's talking to the children, small children. When a person is adult, can differentiate. You know, children, if you have a child, 10 years old, 12, when he say children here, by the way, he meant that like, what you call today,
child labor, 12 years old and so forth, don't let them grow on this. When they grow up, then they can differentiate. You get my point? But the child, you know, don't put that. Give them knowledge, give them ilm. And now Athani, and look at this very important thing Imam Ghazali is going to talk about. Other problems here. ترويج الزيف من الدراهم في أثناء النقد فهو ظلم. You know what that means? تزييف النقد. تزييف النقد. You have to remember that the currency during Imam Al-Ghazali rahmullah time is what? Made of what? Silver and gold. Therefore, there's something called dinar. A dinar made of gold. Dirham made of silver. How do you know this is dirham and this is dinar?
By weight.
By weight and?
Color.
And they used to stamp it. Like there's something, they make a hole in it, they make something. This shows it have the, there's a particular way producing what they call the dirham and the dinar. There's some people, they mix silver with something else, mix gold with something else. And they said this is a dinar. What do you call this? Is fake, kind of fake money. Tazyif al-umla. People do this a lot for the $100. It's true or not? That's why sometimes you go to a particular country, and the person takes the $100 does what? Look at it like this.
Oh, they have machines.
Or the machine, because they want it to be what? A fake hundred. Look to what the Imam Al-Ghazali was saying. He said one of the dangerous things that happened to the economy, where there's a fake money or money laundering taking place in the market. He said the person should not engage in such a thing. Okay? إِذْ يَصَدُرُ بِهِ الْمُعَامِلِ إِنْ لَمْ يُعْرَفْ. The person that the people, when they exchange this currency, there'll be harm and darar because he will not be able to differentiate between right currency from the false currency. وَإِنْ عَرِفَ فَسَيُرَوُجُهُ عَلَى غَيْرِهِ. He said that if a person come to know the money was given to them is not pure, you should not pass it on other people. فَكَذَلِكَ الثَّالِثُ وَالرَّابِعُ وَلَا يَزَالُ يَتَرَدَّدْ فِي الْأَيْدِي وَيَعُمُّ الضَّرَرُ. He said, become people start using from one hand to another hand, and now the harm is spread. Okay? وَيَتَّسُعُ الْفَسَادِ, and corruption will be what? Being expanded. وَيَكُونُ وَزْرُ الْكُلِّ وَوَبَالُهُ رَاجِعًا إِلَيْهِ. If a person initiate fake money, he said, whoever used this money to buy something with it, and it become not of value, everyone, any transition, a person initiated that, he get the ithm out of it. Yani, as if you commit this theft so many times, multiple times. Because you give it to somebody, that person gave it to somebody, that person sold it. All of this chain, the person who started has the ithm. He earned all the sin of all of those people. Right? فَإِنَّهُ هُوَ الَّذِي فَتَحَ الْبَابِ. It's the person who initiated this about inshallah is here. قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Rasulullah sallam said, مَنْ سَنَّ سُنَّةً سَيَّةً. Whoever started a bad habit or a bad custom. فَعَمِلَ بِهَا مَنْ بَعْدِهِ. And whoever come and follow them in that footsteps. كان عليه وزرها ومثل وزر من عمل بها لا ينقص من أوزارهم شيئا. That person then have the sin of their first act, and the sin of ever followed them in the customs without diminishing anyone's sin. وقال بعضهم إنفاق درهم زيف أشد من سرقة 100 درهم.
said to spend a fake, $1 fake, is greater than stealing $100. Yani just you need Imam Al Ghazali to use his book as a manual in the market, global market today, and then we'll be okay. لأن السعر سرق معصية واحدة وقد تمت وانقضت وإنفاق الزيف بدعة أظهرها في الدين والسنة سيعمل بها من بعده فيكون عليه وزرها بعد موته إلى 100 سنة أو 200 سنة سبحان الله. He said that person, even after they die, as long the dollar or the money is in the hand of the people, he get the sin even after 200 years. لا إله إلا الله. Person have to be careful. إلى أن يفنى ذلك الدرهم until the dollar is not no longer exist or the dirham ويكون عليه ما فسد من أموال الناس بسنته and whatever caused the loss of wealth and properties is on him وطوبى لمن مات ماتت معه ذنوبه والويل الطويل لمن يموت وتبقى ذنوبه 100 سنة ونكتب ما قدموا وآثارهم نبل الإنسان يمودي بما قدم أخر. والله تستحي. He said that give good news and glad tidings to the person when they die, they see the star. But warn people when they die, the sin is continue because they establish industry that is continue creating one sense. I give you a very sad story. I will end this class. This is a true story. Happened 2 years ago, and 1 year and a half. One person has an account with the company that produced pornography. He has an account. He paid them $60. One of the sheikhs said it, and the family of the man came to the sheikh. Well-known story, 1 year and a half. One of those Gulf countries. He put the account, and then they have something in the account that is called share. You can share the account. There's a price, $60 to share this many people. He starts sharing it with friends, sending them to their phone. He died, an accident, gone, it's gone. His friend got scared. Therefore, they went and told the son of this guy, said, listen, your father this and that. I'm sorry to tell you that, but you need to stop it. The company in the state, they said, we will not stop it because the person who had paid for it, he has to make the phone call. The contract has to go for 2 years. Imagine a person dead in their grave and sin being spread in his name. They held us for 2 years. He's in the grave and the sin is continuing. What is this? A person should not do something that when they die, it's still people committing sins in their name and they have not initiated that sin. A'udhu Billah. You're 6 feet under and the sin kept coming. A'udhu Billah. Follow the Imam Al-Ghazali, say, be careful. استغفر الله اللهم بحمدك لا اله الا انت استغفرك ولك والعصر ان الانسان لفي خسر الا الذين امنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر جزاكم الله خير السلام عليكم
الله اكبر الله اكبر